Okay, so we introduced the notion of slicing and dicing vectors by looking at the dot product. We then showed how this led to a new notation for expressing algorithms. And then we showed how to translate an algorithm expressed with that notation into code. What we're going to do next is show how to use slicing and dicing for the Axpy operation. Let's illustrate this by looking at two vectors of size 5 with which we're going to perform an Axpy operation. Now remember, an Axpy is alpha x plus y. So this is our scalar alpha, this is our vector x, and this is our vector y. Also recall that in the Axpy operation, all you do is you multiply the scalar times each of the components of x, and then you add that to the corresponding component of y. Now, notice that if we partition the vectors as such, then all you have up here is the Axpy with these vectors and the scalar, which is summarized right there. And at the bottom here, what you have is the Axpy of this times that vector added to that vector, which is summarized right there. So, how to do an Axpy operation with sliced and diced vectors, partitioned vectors, is pretty straightforward. So, more generally, if you want to do alpha times x plus y, then you can take your vectors x and y and partition them into a top part and a bottom part. And as long as vectors x0 and y0 are the same size as our vectors x1 and y1, then the result is just alpha times x0 plus y0 for the first part of the result vector, and alpha times x1 plus y1 for the second part of the result vector. We can obviously extend this. We can take our vectors x and y, partition them into many subvectors, where all that's important is that the corresponding subvectors are of the same size, and then all you get are Xp's with the corresponding subvectors. So, in summary, what we just discussed tells you how to slice and dice the Axpy operation.